Hi, I'm Renee Latosa, and we're going to be demonstrating some of the topics, some of the subject matter that we're going to bring to you at the TANFA seminar. And what you have to do is make sure that you understand that this is a weapon, has to be treated like a weapon, and you must use it with caution. And it's not a seminar that you're going to be doing tricks at, you're going to be doing this, you're going to be doing that, you're going to move it this way. It's a seminar where you're going to understand how to make a transition from TANFA to empty hands, to using the weapon, to making the hits, the different aspects of using the TANFA. But you have to understand it still falls within the realm of the Filipino martial arts. So, first off, what I want to do is make sure that everybody understands that every weapon is fallible. And so, it has its weaknesses, it has its advantages, but what I'm going to give you is the best that you can do with this, and not give you anything that will put you in harm's way. Okay? So, first thing, one of the things we're going to show you is basically how to hold the TANFA in the first way, and we're going to show you a couple of blocks on it, right? Which is okay, just to get a kind of a definition of what we do. But that's just a basic element, okay? But we're going to be able to take that TANFA, use it for a defensive weapon, but also take the TANFA, use it as an offensive weapon, whether it's this way, whether it's this way, whether it's this way, whether we use it from here, we use it from there, we use it to come in and use it as an empty hands process, boom, to make the hits, to make the movements. What I want to make sure that you understand that this is a versatile weapon, and how you grab it is how you use it. You may not ever have the time to grab it like this. What if you grabbed it like this? Can you still use it? If you grab it like this, can you still use it? If it's grabbed like this, if it's grabbed in the middle. Basically, if you stick with the Scrima system that I teach, this becomes a weapon, period. How it looks, how it feels, how it moves, how it reacts is all dependent upon how you use it within the concepts and the confines of what I teach. We're also going to take you into the world of using this as an offensive weapon, taking out the stigma of having this as your only as your defensive weapon, and then coming around and doing this, which in essence, what you do, you loosen the grip of a weapon in a fight and an incident, and you, that's not what you want to do. You want to make sure that when you have something, you have a good grip on it, that you know it's stable, that you can use it, you can always use it. But what we're going to be learning is how to make a hit, a normal hit like this. We're going to learn how to hit with this, learn how to hit when it's here, learn how to hit when you pick it up, bang, boom, boom, boom. Just learn how to hit with this in general, because you just pick it up, and that's the way you use it. If I have to use it here, bang, I'm going to hit here. If I have to go here, boom. Use here, boom, boom. Use it with something, and then you make the transition from using this, which can hit from here to here to here, which then relates to this. Bang, bang, bang. Right? Which you put the power into the hit. Boom, boom, boom. Because if I can hit them like this, is there really a need to swing the weapon like this? But there's also a need to make sure you can boom, 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 use it with the various angles of the weapon. But this, the TANFA, gives you the ability to train the different hits, right? If I'm coming in with the TANFA in here, bang, I can move it up here. Which means that I'm going to take the TANFA, boom, boom, which actually depicts that this is a straight shot in, bang, bang, and not having to, when you hit with a TANFA, it trains you not to break your wrist on any of the hips. Right? Tantra keeps it straight, keeps it in line. So you learn how to make the proper hits. Look at this. From here, bang, boom. Okay, you can make a hook. And the hook is related to the power and the strength of the tantra, right? Boom, boom. And then boom, boom. And all those can become tantra hits, right? Bang! Boom, boom, boom. I'm coming in. Bang, bang! The first part, an initial stage of the seminar, is going to be based around the tantra. And then we're going to kind of reverse engineer it and go back into how do you teach the basics, which will all fall in line with the more advanced movements of the tantra, and going back and learning what the basic elementary meaning is, or what the elementary training things are in the elementary schema, and learning how to relate the concepts to what you do. Okay? And that is in October.
Yes.
So, hope to see you there. And it's an open seminar. You can ask all the questions you want, and it'll be fun, and it'll be also a learning experience. And for those who have never been involved in what I do, it's a training session for you. It's not a group. Everything you learn is going to be geared to yourself. It's going to be all style neutral. There's no egos, there's nothing involved other than trying to learn something and trying to pick up new efficiencies, new energies, and how to make other things work within the confines of what I teach. So come and have fun.
Hallo, Großmeister Latosa hat euch gerade den Umfang erklärt des anstehenden Seminars im Oktober. Es ist wie immer verbandsoffen. Wir freuen uns auf eure Teilnahme. Kommt zahlreich. Es ist für alle interessant, die etwas über Tantra lernen wollen und vor allen Dingen, die auf die Tantra oder den Einsatz Universalstock in ihrem Beruf zurückgreifen müssen, wie zum Beispiel Polizei, Polizeieinsatzkräfte. Kommt alle zahlreich, lernt eine Menge dazu, habt keine Angst, es gibt keine Politik, die wollen wir nicht haben, es geht nur darum zu lernen. Das Seminar findet am 15. Oktober, wie immer, in Velbert statt, seit Jahren unsere Lehrgangsreihen mit Großmeister Latosa. Vielen Dank, bis bald.